When data is mapped from its input dimension into the quantum computer's Hilbert space, it intrinsically becomes cast into a higher dimension. I'll cast you into a higher dimension. Welcome back to another episode of Coding with Qiskit. I'm your host, Jin. This week, we're going to be combining two really hot topics, quantum computing and machine learning. And if you're new to this series, each week we talk about different quantum algorithms, so make sure to like and subscribe. The example that we'll be coding today is a quantum support vector machine. So let's first talk about what a normal support vector machine does. Essentially, this is a way for a computer to learn how to classify data into two different sets. Let's go through a simple example. Let's take a look at my aquarium. So in my aquarium, I have a school of fish, these are ember tetras, and a colony of shrimp. When I feed them, the fish will crowd to the spot where their food is, and the shrimp will crowd to the area in the tank where their food is. And if I'm looking at the tank from the front, and I have a list of the locations of each shrimp and fish in the tank in this XY plane, I can infer by the position of each critter in the tank whether it's a shrimp or if it's a fish. So now if I add a new critter to the tank, the idea is to be able to classify it as a shrimp or a fish based on its position in the tank. So if we have this training set of data, we can find a line, or more generally, a hyperplane, that can divide the space so that on one side of the tank, the critters are classified as shrimp, and on the other side, they're classified as fish. So this is all very nice. But what happens if the animals are arranged so that we can no longer draw a nice line that separates our two classes? Let's see what happens when I'm not feeding them. Because the fish are schooling fish, they'll tend to bunch together. However, the shrimp will tend to disperse themselves randomly in the tank. So how do we classify the animals into shrimp or fish based on the location data now? The answer is to introduce what's called a feature map. So what we're going to do is map the location of each critter from the 2D plane into a higher dimension, K. Now what we can do is compute the optimal hyperplane in some higher dimension that can separate the two classes. This involves computing the distances between our data points within the higher dimensional space. So if K is very large, finding these distances can be very computationally expensive. So a simpler thing to do is to use what's called the kernel trick. The kernel is some easily computable function that takes your two data points and gives back a distance. And the kernel can be optimized in order to maximize the distances between our two classes of data. Unfortunately, some kernel matrices are difficult to compute classically, so this is where the quantum computer comes in. If the kernel cannot be estimated classically, quantum machine learning shows a lot of promise in being able to use the multi-dimensional computation space of the quantum computer in order to find a hyperplane. When data is mapped from its input dimension into the Hilbert space of the quantum computer, it intrinsically is cast into a higher dimensional space. And as we showed, finding a dividing hyperplane is often only possible in a higher dimension. So now let's program a quantum SVM with Qiskit. So the first thing I'm gonna do, as always, start up my environment, conda activate, coming with Qiskit, and this is where I have Qiskit installed. And I'm gonna quickly install one thing that I need for this. So I'll do pip install Qiskit aqua CVX. All right, so now I'm gonna start up a Jupyter notebook. I'm gonna start a new Python 3 notebook. All right, so start with my imports. Import Qiskit. I'm gonna import some stuff from matplotlib, so I can do some plotting. Import NumPy. Import some of my machine learning tools from Qiskit. And this data set is the ad hoc data set, but we have a couple of other data sets that can be used as well. And the ad hoc data set is just a curated data set that we can use for demonstration purposes. I'm gonna import my basic error simulator. I'm gonna import my quantum instance. This will run my experiment. I'm gonna import my feature map. This is my quantum feature map. I'm gonna import my quantum SVM, QSVM, and a few last utilities. Split dataset to data and labels, and map label to class name. Whoopsie. Qiskit. Typo. There we go. All right, so let's set up our quantum SVM. So I'm gonna set my feature dimension to 2. Training set data size says my initial training data set. My testing data set, this is the data set that I want to classify. Plug in some random seeds to randomize things. I'll set my shots to say 10,000. This is for my simulator. Okay, let's set up my data. Sample total. Training input, test input, class labels, and we'll pull these from my ad hoc data. Training size is equal to training data set size. Test size equals testing data set size. Gap is equal to 0.3. So this is a gap in my higher dimensional space that will separate my data and the ad hoc data. And it's going to be my feature dimension. And let's go ahead and plot this data. Okay, and then set up my data points. Split data set to data and labels for my test input. Print class to label. Okay. All right, so this is my ad hoc data. This is my training data that will train my QSVM in order to classify some test data. So now let's set up my backend to actually run the QSVM. I'm gonna use the basic air chasm simulator. Okay, let's plug in my feature map. Easy feature map. Plug in my feature dimension and the reps. All right, and let's set up my support vector machine. Plug in my feature map, my training input, test input, plug in my random seed for my SVM. Set up my quantum instance, and this will actually run my experiment. plug in my backend, shots equals shots, seed simulator, it's gonna be a random seed, seed transpiler is also a random seed. Okay, and then let's get the result back. Oopsie. A little typo here. Shots is equal to shot. There we go. So what I just did here was I set up my backend, I set up my feature map, and plugged it into my quantum support vector machine. So I have my feature map here, my training data, and my test data that I want to classify. And I'm gonna have my backend run this in a quantum instance. All right, so let's take a look at what our kernel matrix looks like from our result. And once again, this is sort of the distance between each of our points in the higher dimensional space. Okay, kernel matrix is equal to the result. And just grab the kernel matrix during the training. And I'm gonna plot this. AS matrix, the kernel matrix, interpolation, set that to nearest, the origin, set that to upper, and then our color map we'll set to bone R. Now let's show this. So this is what our kernel matrix looks like. And you'll notice that along the diagonal, we just have black squares. And all this means is that the distance from each point to itself is zero. And what we're seeing here is the computed distance from the kernel in the higher dimensional space. All right, so now let's look at how well our QSVM has predicted our ad hoc data. SVM predict, data points zero, data points. Predicted classes, map label to class name, predicted labels, and the SVM label to class. Okay, so we're gonna print the ground truth. This is what we know the labels, the classification to be. Oops, ground truth. Format, data points, and then print the prediction and see how well our QSVM has predicted our test data points. Predicted labels. And then let's also print the testing success. So see how well our prediction works overall. Testing accuracy. All right, so here we go. So we have this set of test data where we know the ground truth of what they should be classified as, zero or one. And our prediction, which was trained from our training data, has accurately predicted how to classify our testing data. And we get a testing success ratio of 1.0. So that means we've perfectly predicted our testing data. So there we have it. In this episode, we used Qiskit in order to classify our ad hoc data using a quantum support vector machine. Why don't you try to run the quantum support vector machine with another data set? We'll put links in the description below. Next week, we're gonna talk about the most famous quantum algorithm, Searle's algorithm. So be sure to like and subscribe. Okay, see you next time.